Welcome to another Mycology and Chill. I'm Jesse and I forgot my lab coat. Well, this isn't the particularly sterile part, but still, it has a pocket filled with things that I need. In reality, I don't even think that I'm technically qualified to be even Dr. House. So now, I'm going to open up the chat. It's working, and I just don't want to look at myself. Well, it's not doing it to Instagram Live, so I'll have to upload after I'm done. Something about Yellow Duck not working right, but I spent all day shaving yaks. So, shaving yaks is a tech nerd term. By the way, I'm a nerd. Super nerd. And I really want to fix Instagram, but silly. What am I doing? I'm making liquid cultures. So I'm going to turn this heat down a whole bunch. Let it simmer down. Liquid cultures, what you do is you inject liquid cultures with either another liquid culture. I believe you can, I've never done it before, but you can actually inject them with spores, but I need to double check that. Most of the time I use little slices of agar. I love those little slices of agar because once you drop them inside of a liquid culture, you can just watch the mycelium just like spiral off of them. It's pretty great. Anyway, on to this. I need to actually focus so that I don't burn myself, which I have done many times. Now my goal is to make a whole bunch of these. We'll see how many I get through. Whoa, made a mistake. They got too hot. Should have taken it off the heat before I dropped that in, but oh well. See, the nice thing about this is that the measurements don't actually have to be precise. The less, as long as you don't have too high of a ratio of nutrients to liquid, then you're fine. If you've got too many nutrients versus just pure water, then you've got a problem. But in this case, I happen to lose the same amount of culture and water. But just to be on the safe side, Watertown, party of one. I gotta stop looking at the laptop and start looking at the camera. This streaming thing is really hard. One of my kiddos, was explaining to me that she's gonna take over my channel when COVID is over and she can come and see me. And I was like, what do you mean take over my channel? I think I'm doing okay. Just sort of stumbling by doing science stuff, which is great. And growing mushrooms, which is also great. And studying fungi, which fungi are not plants. Fungi are more closely related to animals than they are plants, meaning we share a common ancestor with fungi as opposed to plants. So we spend more time with fungi on the evolutionary tree. Plants split off way early. Anyway, so that was a hot mess. I don't have to re-sterilize everything, but that's cool. I didn't light anything on fire this time. Also, I was just told to move the mic closer because of the fan. Yeah, so one of the things, and I'll explain this for anybody who's actually dialed in. I really actually don't know and I can't tell. So let's go to chat again. Browser. Well, I can't see anything, so I know nothing. And apparently comments are shut off for something or other, so God only knows what's actually happening. So now that I have made a mess, well, I'm going to pause. I'm going to say, I'm going to pull up my channel, see if I can pull up the link to my event, so then that way I can share it on Twitter. And I am live streaming. Hashtagging anything and my description suck, but hey, it's a first try. And for the record, a friend of mine just posted something. Anyways, so well, that thought's gone. Anyways, this is now warm enough. I'll clean all that up in a second. Now, I'm not too worried about the microphone being down like this. I've already sterilized it, and not only have I sterilized it, but the flow hood, I've got it cranked up so that I can at least hit 196 feet per second, per minute.
Oh,
holy Jesus. All the way back here. So that way, that means I have a nice consistent airflow all the way back here to give me a nice working space. As long as I don't hit the middle, which I always do. But, anyway. So, time to mix this up. Now I'm a DJ.
Wiki wiki woo! Woo 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 woo!
So, anyways, the liquid culture is once you inoculate it, which is basically the introduction of life, bacterial life, or fungal life, whatever, into something. And so when you inoculate it and you drop something in there, either a slice of agar or other liquid culture or, you know, something else to get it started, very similar to like having a sourdough starter. For everybody who decided to become a baker during COVID. Once you inoculate it, then the mycelium starts to grow in this beautiful, you know, suspended state. And actually, while that's mixing, let me grab something. This is my incubation tent. No, there's nothing weird going on here. It's literally a dark tent with a heater in it that's regulated very carefully. Do not personally recommend setting this up unless you really want to get into mushrooming or mycology or whatever you want to call it. Mushrooms, fungi. So, here's a good example. This is my morel. You can see this beautiful cloud down here. That's all morel mycelium. This is malt extract, so you can see they kind of dance around like sea monkeys now. That's a fungi. Sea monkey! Woo-hoo! Anyways. Another example. These are pink oysters. As you can see, there's almost no uncolonized state in here. These pink oysters grow very, 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 very fast. Now, what do you use liquid culture for? Liquid culture to inoculate grains, corns, or other things. And so this is an inoculated morel jar. This is corn in here that I made. I made everything here. Except for the corn. I didn't grow the corn. But regardless. Anyways, so this is the next stage. I take the liquid culture I'm making here, I inoculate that, then I use that, create the gold syringe, go squirt that in. This is a mushroom mycelium. You can see the mycelium. The mycelium is the combined form. And each individual thread is the hyphen. Now, what do I do with the corn? Well, with the corn, I put that into a wood-based substrate that is organic, vegetarian, vegan, you name it, etc. And I sell these on my site. This is a black pearl oyster. I inoculated this on the 11th, so it's only been a couple of days, and you can see how crazy fast the growth is. Somebody, one of my customers, is going to be really happy. That's super fast. It's actually kind of scary fast. So, Anyways, if you check out the site, you can see I sell those in all sorts of forms and factors. Which is cool. What was I doing? Making liquid culture, making liquid culture, making culture, making liquid culture. Now this is not any, this does not have to be sterile because it's all going in pressure. Oh, that's still hot as hell. Now, is everything I'm doing here needed to grow mushrooms? No. Never is. I'm a little extra. But more importantly, I'm also growing and cultivating other people's food and things like reishi and other medicinal mushrooms for people. And I don't want to contaminate them. And so all of my precautions here are mostly to help other people. More importantly, I don't want to get dog hair or dandruff or loose hair or anything else in somebody's food, much less my own. In fact, I eat enough dog food, dog hair on a daily basis to probably ruin my gastrointestinal tract. So what's going to happen next is this got me a whopping maybe 3 jars, and so that's 3 liters. But now that I've got 3 of them, I have to make a heck of a lot more. But I always forget the recipe because there's a very specific ratio. And I just hate it when I do that. That is not a full jar. Waste not, want not. Ooh, that's alright. So what I'm trying to do is figure out the ratio of water to malt extract agar. Malt. One tablespoon to 1 cup of water or 250 ml. Yeah, that's right. 250 ml. So a 1,000 ml. You know, last time I did this, I actually screwed up and I used malt extract agar. Agar is a solid. Guess what happened? Yeah, I had to throw everything out. That was not cool. Also, it's sticky as shit. Oh my god. Of course, it's just sugar jello, so. It's like pouring myself. I covered myself in hot candy. Except it was candy for mushrooms. Alright. Got that. In a second, I need to go grab a tool. Okay, so where did you put it, dude? There it is. Tablespoon dried malt extract. Pilsen light dried. If you need to know where to find this, go to a brewery store. A home brewing store for beer? Yeah, they carry this stuff. Whole bunch of it. Alright, I got it silent. I gotta silence this gear. It's my better half. And I just told her that. There we go. I apologize for doing that in the microphone, but this is thirsty work. Number one, it's already dry. Don't even miss me. Colorado, go home, you're drunk. All right. I just want to simmer this one. And then, before I pour this in this time, I'm going to take it off the heat so it doesn't boil over like a bloody volcano like it just did. Jesus Christ. Now I'm going to pull this out. Again, this part doesn't have to be sterile. It's all going to go into the pressure cooker for 30 minutes at 15 PSI. That's hot. 15 hot tamale. Making liquid culture. Making liquid culture. You know, this entire hobby is, or profession now, is worth it, if nothing more than for the fact that I get to use stuff that looks like this, which is very science-y. I mean, check this dope shit out.
Water, 1.1, 1.2, I can't go any faster!
So, funny story about these. I don't know, like, I wasn't sure how to use them at first, and, yeah. So, they kept skipping across, so, when you're doing this, and I'll show it to you, you can turn it up too high and it will shoot to the side. Like the magnet unit just goes too fast and it can't move through the liquid that fast. Or the solution, whatever you're working on. And instead it'll shoot over to the side and I'm sitting there shaking it back and forth trying to get it in. I haven't turned the magnet off and I've got hot liquid just like bursting all over the place. I'm like, oh! Then I finally turned off the magnet and shot back to the center. I was like, oh, okay. Then I went down and cried for like 20, 30 minutes. It was pretty great. So, she's telling me nice things. Anyway, so I now have 1, 2, 3 jars. And like I was saying earlier, it's like, if you get a little bit low on this, like if this is a little bit less than a tablespoon, you're fine. Because the mycelium will still colonize. It's when you get too much of this, that's when you can have serious contamination issues. Now, I'm using BPA-free plastic lids, and I've explained on other videos how I craft the lids and the jars, etc. You really want everything to be hyper clean, so you can see it's got this micron filter patch, it's got this self-healing injection port, you know, basically I don't want to open anything up and it's going to be clean, it's going to be sterilized, over and over and over again, yeah. Also, these plastic lids don't rust, that's all I'm saying. Alright, that is warm enough. All I need it to be is warm enough to melt the DME. Not boiling, which is a mistake I keep making.
Oh no! It's time for Red October!
I need one pig. One pig only for shilling. And no, I don't. You know, I tend to listen to a lot of things. Earlier I was listening to a playlist called Stoner Doom Metal, which is actually quite nice. It's got quite a bit of really, actually, really nice metal. Love it. And so I listen to a lot of things. But lately I've been listening to the playlist Start Select on on Spotify when working in here, just because it's got a nice tempo and over metal, and it's and I don't feel like I have to yell above it.
Like, hello, welcome to the laboratory. I'm screaming.
Now I know because of the blow hood, you probably wish I was screaming, but oop, that's not enough. I need two more. And so you can see I'm not really filling it up each time. A little bit less. That way I don't have too many contamination issues. Unfortunately, this stuff, when it starts getting humid, as soon as it basically hits liquid, and that can be just ambient humidity too, especially coming up out of this glass. When the climate air is hot, things don't react too well to the liquid. So yeah, so watch. You can turn it up too high. And it starts like warbling all over the place. In this case, it can move enough. But you can hear it's not running right. Here, it's a little bit more happy and stable. Anyway. More likely, I'm probably just bullshitting you. It's all magic, anyways.
Erudition.
Still can't see anything for chat, but I don't see nothing right now. Otherwise, everything else looks fine. With this, it's always a struggle between my ADHD and me. Like, how long can I do a given task, given there are so many different tasks I would very much like to do emotionally at that particular moment in time, which is literally all of it at once. So, it's a problem. I should probably be a good amateur mycologist and finish this batch so I don't curse myself later. But, frankly, now I do all of my work, or I try to do all of my work, thrown off the flow, but just out of habit. I've had contamination issues in the past because I've got chickens, I've got vegetables, people get sick, people have antibiotics in their systems, people sneeze in the greenhouse. And so basically with growing mushrooms, you know, a sneeze isn't going to kill them, it just makes it contaminated. And it doesn't look as nice, it doesn't grow as fast. Because generally speaking, it's fighting with penicillin or another competing bacterium or fungi. And, you know, contamination can be really bad too. Things like black mold, spore lung, those things are real risks. But you don't actually have to worry about that unless you're actually working at scale, usually. But it's something to keep in mind and, you know, not mess up. So now I've got 1, 2, 3, 4. Man. I guess it's liquid culture night.
and scarf downward of my frittata.
Frittata.
Yes, I could make more in one single batch, but I have screwed that up more times than I care to admit. So I always try to stick to a 1,000 milliliter batch. Or a little bit less than that. Again, for those of you just turning in who are horrified that not all of this is sanitary right now, remember, it goes into the pressure cooker. It gets sterilized again. And again, and again. It's like the hot chip song, over and over and over and over and over again. Go back to the dirty dishes. Tablespoon to 250 milliliters of water. And that's my third one. And I really hope this is my fourth one. So now I've lost count. Welcome to ADHD. Party of one. No, it's not a party. Pit strike bolt extracted.
Oh, God, Lord! Jesus, that was a mistake.
Oops, I didn't warm it up before I did this. Anyways.
test. Grab it. If it's hot, it's hot.
No, but seriously, I was. I'll move the pressure cooker in a second. sort of cleaning up as I go so I don't have mass regrets like I had in the past of, oh yeah, I'll just clean that up later. And then I'm walking here. Speaker on super loud. I had the one in the basement. First world problems. I wonder what I wrote downstairs trying to speaker up that loud. Well, now I'm going to rewind it so you get to hear it again. Sorry. Not sorry. This is what happens when Sonos won't rename your speakers from Office, and you have two Office. Hashtag first world problems. I had those damn things for years. Biscuit in again. Did somebody just laugh? Where'd it go? I'm a magician. It's a magnet. The sound of somebody laughing was the dogs making barking sounds at mailman who we've been at war with forever. Oh, I'm grinding my teeth too. Oh, this sucks. Alright, you can actually go on the floor. This is hot and dirty. First up, we've got some agar corn transfers. So what this is, I actually got an order in for king oysters, and so I want to make it fresh. I mean, admittedly, I could already fulfill it based off of what I have, but I'm at least starting so I can rotate in some new kings, because obviously other king oysters want to leave. Making fresh ones. From this. This is a populated agar plate. King Oyster made it on 6/29. It's been in the refrigerator. Yes, you store things in the refrigerator to make it hibernate. That's not weird or creepy at all. Ooh, my next highly technical science tool, cooling rack. This allows me to put everything up into the laminar flow, which is a Pearl Jam song.
Laminar flow floats around like butterflies.
See that, Maskators? Waiting for my head. I'm in front of a laminar flow hood, which technically I could be sneezing here and it. Well, maybe that's excessive. But, yeah. This is my force field. So, actually, I'll give you a better shot. Two corn jars.
Two corn jars.
Sterilize. Yes, I have a mason jar full of alcohol sterilizer. Now that's not isopropyl. Otherwise I'd be crying a little bit, but using 99% isopropyl because it absorbs, it like destroys on liquid. H2O. Oh, with the blood sugar crashing. Finish this.
Finish her.
That popped off, which is nice. I'm actually happy that that popped off when it did, because if I had already inoculated this, I would have been really irritated. Again, I'm going to stress that I've already sterilized everything. So if you're actually in the trade, stop being horrified. You can also sterilize different species. All right.
Shall we begin?
Again, lab coat serves a purpose. Also keeps my army hair and everything else from flying all over the place. Yeah.
take the lids off before I heated the blade, so. I'm gonna re-sterilize it here in a second. Technically don't need to because I'm in formula flow mode, in theory, but. This. Sorry, it's going to be hard to impossible for you to see everything. Oysters, I actually don't have to use a lot of agar to inoculate a given jar of corn. The thing grows like a virus, so it's pretty great. Sorry, that was a terrible reference, I'm sorry. This one I'll give a bigger slice to. How's that? Doesn't matter how I cut up this particular mycelium with this agar plate, just that I get this in and I get it inoculated. Now, most of the time I actually end up just using an entire one of these, but I'm actually trying to see if I can use a little bit less for these jars, so that's why I did that. I've already proven that it can work for the wine caps and some of the other species. I just want to see it work on the king oysters. Usually I slice up an entire one like a pizza and drop all of the slices in. I didn't put that in my sterile spot because I'm a dummy. Have a real good weekend, and I appreciate you, so chilling.